Thank you all, and welcome to the world famous Double DeLorean right here in Charlotte, North Carolina. We appreciate y'all coming out.
You're the solid center, babe.
This is the story of the Double Door Inn, a neighborhood bar turned world-famous music venue. Owner Nick Karas has worked alongside his staff for over 30 years to keep their home away from home and Charlotte's grassroots music scene alive and kicking. The Double Door Inn is not a story of corporate greed or fast fame. It is a story of people searching for musical camaraderie and a bit of fun.
Hello Erin, my name is Nick Karas. Welcome to my messy office. And I've had the Double Door for almost 36 years. We would be open 36 years this coming December 22nd. Charlotte was unbelievably different back then. Unbelievably different. There were some bars for older men, you know, like our dads or something, you know, places where they could go. But bars for young people, you know, 18 and up to their 20s, there weren't but a couple. In Charlotte, just a couple. This building originally was a residence. Then Peggy Houston opened it as a lamp shop. So she was quite successful with Peggy Houston's lamp shop. All the ladies knew it. I was working for a real estate company. I was the leasing agent for this building. Again, this was in 73, a long time ago. Interest rates were high. You had to put 20% down instead of 5 or 10. So I said, well, yeah, I could just rent this to myself and put a bar in here. That's kind of how it happened. I mean, we just opened a bar here ourselves. So we did.
I was here for the opening night, but I didn't start working for a few years after. And the kind of reason I got the job is I used to come here and drink after hours. I knew Nick and I knew some of the other guys. And there was a bartender here at the time that was going on vacation and nobody worked for him. And he said something, we're all sitting up here, and he goes, hey, you're here all the time, you wanna work? And I said, Nick, you mind? He goes, no, go ahead. So I started working for Nick, and then the guy never came back from vacation and I never left. It was the longest 2 weeks of my life.
And all kind of people come. All kind of people come. We had, of course, the hippie. And I called them the glitter people. We had this southern rednecks. It was really a mix. And it was a mix, really, that some people in Charlotte couldn't deal with. People that I know didn't come here. And I knew, and I quickly figured out they just thought it was rough. But they just thought it was rough because there was such a diverse crowd in here. We were sort of a neighborhood bar then, because young people would just walk over here and hang out.
We used to have a little alcove up there in Nick's office. So when they actually did the 4th of July fireworks, if you got here, we'd rope off the lot. You could drive in, bring your date upstairs, go up there, and the thing, open up the window, crawl through the window, and you can sit out there with your beer and watch the fireworks across the street. I mean, it was cool.
My name is Mikey Davidson. I am the talent buyer for the Double Door Inn, and I handle all of the marketing and advertising.
Micah has really come in, and he's who I need.
Well, we really started having local bands come in.
1975. A lot of the customers came here. Some of them were musicians. And naturally they go, well, can we play? You pay a quarter to go in and hear the music. Maybe 50 cents. And he brought in the Dixie Dregs. I was hooked.
Monday Night All-Stars have been a staple at the Double Door Inn for the past 15 years. Created by Les Moore in the 90s, this band consisted of the most talented musicians in the area. People have come from all over to hear their legendary sound. Sadly, the lead singer and heart of the All-Stars, Charles Hairston, recently passed away. But the All-Stars continue to do him proud every Monday night.
My name is Chris Allen. I play drums with the Monday Night All-Stars. I'm my favorite sax player in the world.
I'm John Alexander. I'm the saxophone player with the Monday Night All-Stars. I have been doing this gig since 96.
You can't find live music like this anywhere else in Charlotte, in my opinion.
Probably Charles was the main attraction, well, probably I should say certainly, Charles is the main attraction from a fan standpoint. From an other musician standpoint, I think the quality of the players certainly, because we'd have a bunch of friends who play come in as well and sit in or hang or whatever. But Charles had an ability to communicate with an audience better than anybody I ever worked with. He could just reach out and grab you.
Charles was Charles, but you know, you look, Mike even said, I never thought I'd miss him like this.
He'd come up to you and start talking to you like he knew you for your whole freaking life. And he made you feel that way. And I mean, he put on a hell of a show. And it was, you know, the charisma, you know, the magic, whatever you want to call it. He had stage presence. I don't care. I don't know what you want to name it. When he hit the stage, the fucking room completely changed.
The Double Door Inn takes its responsibility in the community to heart, holding charity events like Music for More, Habitat for Humanity, and Amp for the Cure. Brace yourself, though. The Double Door Inn doesn't throw your average fundraiser.
Woo! Are you having a good time so far, y'all? Are you having a good time? Yeah!
Yeah! just be mine, baby. Won't you roll my brown and round? I've been gone 6 months, pretty baby. Ain't you heard I'm back in town? Oh, I'm a lemon squeeze with daddy, baby.
Keeping up with the evolution of Charlotte's grassroots music scene, the Double Door Inn makes sure to include all forms of rhythm, rock, and blues in their weekly lineups. Talent buyer Micah Davidson ensures that in this place, there is no average night.
What I'm saying, you don't need no letters on the page.
Characters who run it, many of which have been here since the beginning.
Right on for your feet.
The Double Door is pretty much just kind of a 36-year-old story about people, loving people.
Boom, 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 boom.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. We're just having a bit of fun, darling.
Down the floor. When you're talking to me, that baby talk, I just like it like that.
It might sound cheesy, but this place is a diamond in the rough.
You knocks me out, right off of my feet. How, 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 how.
Oh, people care about that so much.
I love you, baby. Baby! Little baby, ah, yeah, yes, baby, shake it, baby, shake it, baby.
As far as long term, we'll be here. We've been here for 36 years now. I mean, you know, when other stuff has gone on, the Double Door is a constant. I think it'll remain that way.
She walked and walked and talked that talk and whisper in my ear and tell me that she loved me.